I'm not going anywhere until somebody tells me what happened last night, Mom. Would you please fill me in? Mom, Oh, I get it. I'm just here for the comic relief.
Unless I can think of one last grand romantic gesture, summer's gone.
Wow. You know, I remember when I first heard about Summer. We were sailing and you said you named your boat after her, which I thought was a little weird considering you never actually talked to her.
Eureka, Ryan. Can't believe I just said Eureka. That's okay.
That's it.
What's it?
The thing to win her back. The grand romantic gesture that's gonna put Zachary's Euro trip to shame. I shall take her on a sailing adventure aboard the Summer Breeze.
Except you sold the boat for bus fare.
I did. Damn it. Eureka, Ryan! I shall buy back the Summer Breeze!
Yes.
Uh-huh. Except with what money?
Okay, if I wanted my parade rained on, I would just step outside. Let me ask you something. Do you like the shape of the idea, even?
Definitely.
Okay, great. So all I need is money. Hang on. Yes, got the answer. But before I say Eureka again, do you see any other potential flaws or holes in my plan?
No.
Then Eureka, Ryan! You freaking Eureka!
Hey, look. We are where we are, and we'll help you through this. We can do it together.
Hey, man, they raised me, okay? Proof pudding. Speaking of pudding, Mother, do I have any tapioca on tap?
You are king of the segue.
Oh, I just love pudding. It's so fun to say. Pudding. Pudding. Pudding.
It's not a big deal, Seth.
Ryan, my girlfriend dated a girl. It's a very big deal. There's only one thing I can do to make it okay.
You're gonna hook up with a guy?
I repeat, there's only one thing I can do to make it okay. I need to see this girl. Because right now my imagination is just running wild.
Dude, so is mine. She's hot, right?
Listen, I know I'm supposed to be attracted, okay? And I'm supposed to be turned on. I've read Maxim. I've read stuff, but you know what? All it's making me feel like is Alex is even more out of my league.
Well, maybe just wait to talk to her to calm down a little bit.
Nope. Got a lot of testosterone pumping right now, Ryan. Testosterone being the key ingredient missing from Alex's previous relationship. I just need a reminder of that. Come on!
This should go well.
Traffic.
Still broken up over the Alex breakup?
Nope.
It's emotional child's play compared to what we're dealing with now, Ryan.
Hmm?
Summer's back.
Whoa, what?
Yeah, and I don't want it to be, believe me. But apparently, the universe has other plans for us.
The universe is involved now.
Why else would I be forced to go to San Diego with her on the 1 year anniversary of our sexual tete-a-tete, or pas de deux, if you will?
As long as it's not a menage a trois, since you will be going to San Diego with Zach, her boyfriend.
Yeah, and my friend.
Yeah.
Dude, I don't want to go to San Diego, okay? I don't want to go anywhere near summer.
No, but the universe.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, shouldn't be a problem for you. I mean, you and Summer have been friends for a while now, right?
Yes, and I'd be a little more confident about my chances of cheating fate and not cheating if Summer and I hadn't made out.
You guys made out?
No, but our noses grazed, and it was like the most sexually charged nose graze in the history of nose grazes. It's essentially nose humping is what it is. So what am I gonna do?
I'm gonna tell you what you're gonna do. You're gonna go down to San Diego, your friend Summer and her boyfriend, your friend Zach, and you're gonna keep it in your trousers, all right? Nothing can happen. Got it?
Yeah. I have no heart. I hate Valentine's Day.
You'd be off joining a foreign legion, joining a cult. Ryan could be, I don't know, he could be taking place in a mass marriage right now, drinking Kool-Aid from brand new sneakers. So many sick things.
So, you and Jody? Getting back together?
I doubt it. Just kind of a pain in the ass. But maybe that's my type.
Right. So then, I mean, does that mean that we can go back to before? Because I can forget this ever happened. Okay, I'll wait. Because that's what adults do, they wait. So I'm waiting, adult style.
Looking good, nephew Seth.
Thank you.
Puberty happened.
It's been that long.
It sure has. Be glad you missed it. Oh, check this out, though.
Oh. Chest hair. And a new friend?
Yeah, that's right. He's kind of a long story. So what exactly did my mom catch you guys doing?
Nothing.
Nothing, huh? So you guys haven't...
I don't know. We haven't even had our first date yet.
Last night doesn't count?
Nah. Going out Saturday night.
Good. Great. But you have before, right? Okay. Wow, that's what I thought. I just didn't want to jump to conclusions because my experience is sort of limited.
And?
What?
Was it awesome?
Which time?
There were, I don't know, how many times were there?
Same girl or different girls?
There were different girls? How many different girls were there? I have to sit down.
So when you lost your virginity, I was playing Magic the Gathering.
You still play Magic?
Yeah, but not as much. Chrismica.
Chrismica?
That's right, it's a new holiday, Ryan, and it's sweeping the nation.
Hey, fellas, we got the tree.
Hey.
Or at least the living room.
Guys, a little help.
Yeah, just save a spot for you right there. Put your muscle into it.
Excellent.
To the right a little. To the right. Don't hurt it. Those needles are brittle.
That's perfect. You guys, A plus. I love the holidays. I love them all.
We didn't really know how to raise Seth.
Yeah, so I raised myself. And in doing so, I created the greatest super holiday known to mankind, drawing on the best that Christianity and Judaism have to offer.
And you call it Chrismica.
Just hearing you say it makes me feel all festive. Allow me to elaborate. You see, for my father here, a poor, struggling Jew growing up in the Bronx, well, Christmas, it meant Chinese food in a movie. And for my mom over here, Waspy McWasp, well, it meant a tree, it meant stockings and all the trimmings. Isn't that right?
We're very proud.
I'm not a wasp.
Sure you're not. Other highlights include 8 days of presents, followed by one day of many presents. So, what do you think?
Sounds great for you guys.
For you, too.
Hey, dip a toe in the Chrismica pool. There's room for all of us.
She kept saying the word nice. You know what that means, don't you?
Oh, she thinks you're nice.
Yeah, exactly, nice. As in lacking any edge and or danger.
Well, you did offer to fix her a sandwich.
I know. It's like the more edgy and dangerous she became, the more I became like a Jewish grandmother.
Not your grandmother. Keep shucking, Seth. I want dinner ready by the time your mother gets home.
Hey, maybe I don't feel like shucking these. Okay, maybe you should go and shuck them yourself, old man.
It's good. You had me shaking in my boots.
God, I'm so screwed.